Hi Aries, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and let's do an energy check-in for your weekend. So this is the weekend of the 16th of October, Aries, 16th, 17th, 18th, and these are general collective readings. Will not resonate with each and every one of you, so take what works for you, leave the rest. And as I was saying that, this card popped out, the Ace of Swords. I think Aries, you're very, very clear now of your path ahead, right? Sharp-minded. Let's keep this here. I don't know why this card has popped up, but we'll see. Let's stop this reading with an angel blessing card and see what my angels are going to bless Aries with. So my angels, what do you have for Aries? Ooh, okay. Heaven is watching over you. Beautiful. So Aries, you have no worries. All your angels and guides are watching over you, and you have clarity and clear direction in life once again. So let's see what you're going to be doing this weekend. Welcome back, my subscribers. Thank you. You know, I love your comments. You're my favorites. I mean, I love, love, love your comments. You are so sweet. Thank you so much for all your support to my channel. And yes, if you're new here, this is going to be a mini read, just a energy check-in for your weekend. If you enjoy it, do join us, subscribe to the channel. We do serious readings as well, but this is going to be a mini one, just to check how my Aries are going to be doing on this weekend. Yes. So let's see, Aries, the first card I have for you is the Ten of Swords. Ending something and being out of stress and tension. Very nice. You've put an end to something, Aries, here. And finally, you feel relieved. You feel relieved of all your stress, tension, no more overthinking, no more being up at night wondering. You are releasing something, Aries, and that's why you are in the state of total relaxation, I think, this weekend, and very clear-headed. Because you can only get clear-headed if you are not up in your head all the time. Stress will never allow you to make fresh plans, right? So here you are, putting an end to something, not stressed, not worried, releasing something. Let's see. Yes. I think for a very long time, Aries, you've been in a very stuck place with somebody who you considered maybe to be a soulmate. And when you now look back, the memories created with a soulmate are not really the most pleasant. So you've been stuck in your mind for a very long time, wrapped up in this dynamic which happened with the soulmate. But now I think, Aries, you're taking the higher ground here, and you're kind of being defensive, and you're saying, hey, listen, enough is enough. I have spent, wasted enough time being stuck and being in zombie land and thinking about somebody who did me wrong, maybe in the past, but now I'm putting my guard up. I'm not allowing anything to stall my path forward, right? So let's take one clarifier for these, and then I'll open the last three cards. So Spirit, what is Aries putting an end to with the Ten of Swords energy? Yeah, Aries, you are putting an end to any kind of fighting, any kind of conflict, any kind of competition. Maybe the soulmate of yours brought in a lot of conflict, fighting, and you're leaving all that behind, and you're starting something brand new for yourself now. This weekend, you're making plans for something new. You put this old chapter to bed. So, Eight of Swords, Spirit, why is Aries feeling so relieved now? Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords. Eight of Swords. Yes, Aries, this is that same soulmate who you maybe at one time considered to be your best friend, the one you thought, you know, was your everything, a soulmate, best friend, you thought this was going to be maybe your future partner, but this person turned out to be, now you know the truth about this person. You have full clarity about the situation now, and you see them now as being a troublemaker maybe in your life, who was probably a player as well, came in, dipped in and out of your life, kind of an energy. Now that you know the truth, you have clarity, I think you've stopped stressing over it. You've kind of let it go. So let's see this Four of Pentacles. What's Aries releasing now? Yes, you are releasing waiting. Maybe you were waiting for a very long time. Now you're turning your back. You have dropped this issue altogether from your mind. This weekend, I see you giving it all to the universe to say, I have done my best. Let the karma now deal with them, me, whoever, because I'm no longer dealing with it. And that's why you are feeling more stress-free because you are no longer waiting. You've turned your back to this situation altogether. Hanged man spirit, hanged man. Okay, hanged man. Yes, because you were stuck for so long, Aries, you were unable to start anything new for yourself, maybe. You were just waiting and waiting and waiting, and it was hampering your progress. You were not being able to maybe meet new people or move forward in your own life. Now I see this weekend, Aries, you are finally giving up waiting, and you're walking away from being stuck. That's a big thing, right? You're not feeling stuck. If you want to go anywhere, you are free to go, free to talk to anyone, free to call up anyone. You are not putting your mind to the past anymore with the Six of Cups energy, who always, now when you think of them, it doesn't even look that exciting. Yes, you're very clear now. See, second time this Ace of Swords is there. This clarity around the situation in your mind that, you know, this only gave you stress and tension. This thinking back to the past only gave you stress and tension. Looking back to the past only gave you stress and tension. Right? So now you are clear, absolutely, and I think maybe you may be just kind of heading out towards new love now, offering your cup to somebody else, or maybe receiving something new from somebody else this weekend, Aries. Seven of Wands spirit, Seven of Wands, Seven of Wands. Not being able to make a decision, Aries, was stalling you, of your progress. The same message over and over again, but now that you have healed considerably, you've taken some time out, you've been in hanged man's place, you've been stuck for a very long time, but this time also helped, Aries, because you became very clear about what happened, why it happened, and what you need to now release. And after this clarity has come, after this healing has come, Aries, now you are taking the higher road, higher ground, and now you're not allowing anyone to come in who you don't want. You have learnt now. Let's see now your last three cards. Page of Swords, Five of Swords, and the Five of Pentacles. So Aries, you're doing fine, you're all right, but I think your person still is kind of keeping a watch on you. They haven't released you as much as you have released them. They are feeling a bit embarrassed and ashamed of their deeds this weekend. And even if they want to reach out, I think they want to reach out in a sneaky way, you are probably going to leave them out in the cold here. Five of Swords spirit. Five of Swords. Yeah, I think this person has been in isolation for a very long time and not happy without you. They have been keeping an eye on you for sure. Five of Swords. They feel you won. You've won over them, and that you're very angry with them. And even though they played a trick on you, they are the ones who have now kind of been abandoned and left from you, and they are wishing and hoping now to bring some balance back into this equation. Five, yeah, they're feeling abandoned, lost. They feel they lost their chance to have a Ten of Pentacles with you. They don't want to juggle anymore. Too late, buddy, too late. I think they are trying to send you a message, but I don't think you are allowing it, Aries. They are feeling pretty left out and abandoned and unloved, uncared for. This is, if this happens, Aries, this is going to be a huge tower moment in their life. They're not going to be expecting it. That Aries is not even going to. What is this tower moment, spirit? Don't confuse us now. We were going so well with just Aries, and why does this person arrive? I want to know what this tower moment is. What's this tower moment, spirit? What is this tower moment? Okay, somebody wants to have a passionate new beginning. They want to work at it, and then they want to express their love. Okay, and then they are not either. They'll either be rejected, Aries. If somebody comes towards you from your past, they want newness with you. They want love. They want to work on this with you. They are either going to be rejected, or they fear being rejected, and they're going to feel that they lost. Right? So this is going to be a tower moment in their life, that Aries is no longer waiting for them. Sometimes in soulmate connections, Aries, even if you guys are not talking, they can energetically feel your shift. And I see you shifting big time here. You're shifting out of not worrying anymore, not stressing anymore. So even energy exchange is there between soulmates. So they may be also kind of receiving that message that Aries is now, Elvis has now left the building. So this is going to be a huge tower moment weekend for them. And for you, I see you quite relaxed and chilled out and very clear of what you want, what you don't want in your life. Kudos. So that's all I have for you, Aries, for this weekend energy. Love and light. Take care. Namaste.